Well, this afternoon, the University of South Africa, or UNISA, will be launching the newly established Thabo Mbeki African School of Public and International Affairs, which is aimed at nurturing and producing thought leaders and change agents for the reconstruction and development of the continent. Well, joining us to discuss this is the principal and vice-chancellor of UNISA, Professor Mandla Makhanya. Great to have you, Professor. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you so much, Leanne. Great to be with you as well as our viewers.
I must say, it's quite a mandate when we look at what it is about, aimed at nurturing and producing thought leaders and change agents for the reconstruction and development of the continent. Talk to us about this. I mean, how are we hoping to achieve something like that?
No, thank you very much, Leanne. Perhaps just to start off, to know that the mission of the school is basically to offer Africa-centered knowledge and scholarship in governance, diplomacy, and state affairs with a view of achieving African renaissance, you know, and unity. This is critical for our development as a continent because remember that we cannot hope to have any kind of development that is going to be driven externally, as it were. So it is the development that we should be driving ourselves. So from the perspective of the school, we are going to be using the platform from which to launch ourselves, you know, into this work, basing it, you know, on the values that former President Mbeki lived by and professed. But it's not only him, by the way. You must also remember that we have a situation on the continent where we have a number of African thought leaders who were simply committed, you know, throughout the way in which they've conducted themselves and lived by, you know, by their own prescripts to ensure that African renaissance becomes a reality, to ensure that African thought leadership is driven to its logical conclusion, but also to ensure that we take the youth and women to be at the center of ensuring that Africa's development is driven in earnest with everybody's participation. And in doing so, you are bringing not only just the youth and women, but also people with disabilities to have a critical role to play in state affairs.
Yeah.
So the manner in which we are going to be constructing then our curriculum is to ensure that we take those who are practitioners, in particular in the public affairs, to be grounded in this area where we'll then be combining theory with practice so that that which they are doing can then be driven in earnest, you know, to ensure that this development becomes a reality.
Yeah, the idea is fantastic. And I think what makes it even more accessible is, as you mentioned, this is something that's attracting everybody and all walks of life. Doesn't matter where you sort of fit into this world, and that's what I think is so nice. It's everybody is welcome, but it's particularly for students across the continent to study remotely, and that's an important part. It's the remote studying in order to develop, if you like, a newer set of change makers and leaders. So this is at the heart of all of it, and I think that this is a great idea. In terms of the qualifications needed for something like this, is it a postgraduate degree? What is it? How does it actually work?
Yeah, no. That's a very important question, Leanne, because what we've done, I mean, just to briefly explain this, is that you'll be aware that we had established a few years ago at Thabo Mbeki African Leadership Institute, which was primarily offering, you know, short learning programs. But we have seen it fit that what we need to do this time around is to combine all Africa-centered institutes within the university, starting with African Center for African Renaissance Studies, which became an institute at a later stage, the Institute for Alternative Dispute Resolution, but also the Thabo Mbeki African Leadership Institute itself, to pull all of them together to establish this Thabo Mbeki School of Public and International Affairs, with the sole purpose of having now a school that is going to be operating akin to what you'll find, you know, in a faculty. Because in that sense, what we are going to be offering is not only just going to be confined on certificates and short learning programs, which of course will still be pursued by the institute within the school, but the school will primarily be driving the agenda of offering postgraduate programs like honors, masters, you know, and doctoral programs, but also postgraduate, you know, degrees, mainly attracting people who are qualified in various fields, because they, it may be economics, it may be accounting, whatever that field is. What then happens is that as they join the school, they bring to bear that particular knowledge that they already have and their own experiences. And what we do is to imbue this African-centered knowledge that is going to be then at the core of the way in which we expect them to drive the agenda of taking their work forward. Because we are basically trying to bring a new level of consciousness where those that we train are going to be taking whatever they do in the state affairs or public affairs in a manner where they understand the stewardship that is placed on themselves. Because we want to ensure that we treat our own public institutions like protecting your own baby from harm. That's really what it's all about, so that we can be guaranteed that they become the center of attraction. So anyone else who wants to do anything else on the continent and in the diaspora will look at the public or state affairs as the first area where you may like actually to make a contribution. Because by doing so, we are automatically contributing to the people themselves. So that is really how we're going to develop ourselves.
Fantastic. Prof, I could continue asking you a lot of questions about it because it sounds so interesting, and I'm hoping that there's a lot of interest and a lot of students across the continent that sign up for this, because that's the whole idea. I know that there are formal and non-formal programs that are on offer, but the actual launch is taking place today. So it looks like it's happening at 3 o'clock this afternoon. Will this also be virtual? Will we have the presence of our former president Thabo Mbeki there as well? Perhaps you can talk to us very quickly about how the launch is going to take place today.
Thank you very much, Leanne. The launch is taking place this afternoon at 3, as you rightly mentioned. We are going to be having former President Mbeki, you know, as a speaker there. So the launch is going to be virtual. It's going to be very exciting. We're inviting everyone, you know, from all walks of life to participate in this launch so that we can all be au fait with what is going to be happening as part and parcel of our programs in the school. But I can tell you, Leanne, and our viewers, that this is actually the first of its kind on the continent. And we are going to be proud of the work that the school is going to do.
Well, that's a fantastic, fantastic offering. Thank you very, very much, Professor Mandla Makhanya, the Principal and Vice-Chancellor at UNISA, talking to us about the launch of the Thabo Mbeki African School of Public and International Affairs, happening at 3 o'clock this afternoon. It's an online event, and this is aimed at nurturing and producing thought leaders and change agents for the reconstruction and development of the continent, open to all those on the continent. And it is an online offering, as a lot of UNISA's are. Offerings are. So fantastic initiative again. Thanks again to the professor. That leads us up to 7:30 here on the program. Let's quickly bring you up to speed with a news headline.